Dog Anatomy. Bully Badass TV would like to share with all dog lovers the names of your dog's anatomical parts. Some canine anatomical names may be familiar to you. Dogs have elbows and ears and eyes, but other names may be downright foreign. Starting from the head, a dog is made up of the nose, the muzzle, foreface, comprised of the upper and lower jaws. The stop is an indentation, sometimes non-existent, between the muzzle and the forehead. Ears, eyes, whiskers provide some sensory filling. Flews is just a fancy word for a dog's lips. A dog's cheek is the skin along the side of the muzzle. Parts of the neck and shoulders include the nape of the neck is where the neck joins the base of the skull in the back of the head. The throat is beneath the jaws. The crest starts at the nape and ends at the withers. The neck is pretty self-explanatory. It runs from the head to the shoulders. The shoulder is the top section of the foreleg from the withers to the elbow. The withers are the top point of the shoulders, making them the highest point along the dog's back. The back and chest are together because they are part of the dog's torso, which includes the prosternum is the top of the sternum, a bone that ties the rib cage together. The chest is the entire rib cage of the dog. The back runs from the point of the shoulders to the end of the rib cage. The term back is sometimes used to describe the back and the loin. The belly is the underside of the dog from the end of its rib cage to its tail. The loin is the back between the end of the rib cage and the beginning of the pelvic bone. You'd think that the forelegs and the hind legs of a dog would be similar, but they're about as different as your own arms and legs. The elbow is the first joint in the dog's leg, located just above the chest on the back of the foreleg. The long bone that runs after the elbow on the foreleg is the forearm. Like your arms, it's comprised of the ulna and the radius. The wrist is the lower joint between the elbow and the foreleg. Pasterns are equivalent to the bones in your hands and feet, not counting fingers and toes. Dogs have a paw at the end of each leg. The paw comes with nails, sometimes called claws, paw pads, and usually dew claws. The upper thigh is the part of the dog's leg situated above the knee on the hind leg. The lower thigh is the part of the hind leg beneath the knee to the hock. Some dogs have feathering along the back of their lower thighs and hocks. The stifle or knee is the joint that sits on the front of the hind leg in line with the abdomen. The hock is the oddly shaped joint that makes a sharp angle at the back of the dog's legs. It corresponds with your ankle. The parts that make up your dog's rear end include the following. The rump is the proverbial rear end. It's where the pelvis bone is. The top of the rump is called the croup. The tail set is where the tail attaches to the rump. Some dogs have high tail sets, others have low ones. Everyone recognizes the dog's tail. And while selective breeding has changed the appearance of many breeds, all dogs retain the basic anatomical characteristics.